everyone, it's Holly, and I am here with my series review of the Alienated series by Melissa Landers. This is going to cover Alienated, the novella Until Midnight, and Invaded, which is the second book, and the last at this point in time anyways. So this series is basically a sci-fi series that takes place mainly in our world, and what happens is a few years earlier, some aliens that are basically human make contact with Earth, and they kind of start helping Earth, you know, providing medicine and those kinds of things. And so we decide to start having like diplomatic relations with them, and in part of that, trying to get humans more accepting of the aliens and the alien culture more accepting of humans, there's an exchange program. And so Kara, I don't know if it's Kara or Kara, but it's spelled C-A-R-A, and I had a friend with that spelling that said Kara, so I'm saying Kara, is a human, and she ends up taking on Alix as a foreign exchange student. And the story is about them kind of coming to grips with their differences and their similarities, and eventually mutual attraction, and it becomes a romance, but first and foremost it's a friendship, and it's a story of two cultures kind of coming together and learning from one another. I did give Alienated 4 stars, Until Midnight 3.5, and Invaded 4 stars as well. I think it's a strong 4 star series. It's good, it's full of beautifulness, it's got a nice romance, all the fun stuff. So I want to talk about the characters and the writing. So the story is told in like sort of alternating POV. It's not like that POV where a chapter is assigned to anybody. It's kind of what I'm used to reading in romance novels, where it's sort of limited third person. And sometimes you'll just get a page break and it'll switch to the other character's POV. And it does alternate between the two of them, between Alix and Kara. And they are both so stubborn, and they're strong-willed and highly intelligent, so they kind of like have this battle of the wits thing going on all the time, and they both also often, I guess this goes as being stubborn, think that they're right, which is just kind of fun and entertaining to read. Kara is definitely very caring, and she, like I said, is smart. She's also pretty mature. She's gone through some things in her life, and she has a pretty adult-ish outlook on things. I mean, she's a senior in high school, and I kind of like that Melissa Landers doesn't have this girl who's like completely grown up like you see in some books, but she's also not completely immature. Like, she seems to me like a pretty well-rounded senior in high school. Like, where she is and her outlook on life is a lot like the outlook I feel I had when I was that age, and my friends did. So, works for me. Alix definitely initially comes off as being kind of this cold, super reserved person, but he opens up over time. He still has some of those, like, what we would consider as humans, cold traits, but it's just because of how he was raised, which makes sense within like the larger context of the story. Like I said, the romance kind of starts off as a friendship, and that really to me weaves through the whole story. These two people come to respect each other, and they have conversations. And that's another thing about Melissa Landers. She is not afraid to have her characters talk about things, and I just wish you saw more of that, especially in YA. Like, that's, in my opinion, what makes a romance last, is being able to have a conversation and discuss things, whether they be simple day-to-day things or larger political, social things. It is kind of like an enemies to friends to lovers kind of story, which I personally like, so it works. And you can really tell that they care about each other. They're attracted to one another, and sometimes they like can't keep their hands off each other, but at the core they really do care, and their relationship just isn't this like hyper hormonal sexual relationship. And they also don't lose, neither of them loses their personalities to their romance. So obviously they impact one another, that happens. You know, whether it's a friend or a romance, people will kind of alter the way you view things because they're providing a different perspective, and that happens to both of these characters. but they don't lose who they are. They don't change completely for the other person. So I talked about the romance a lot, which is there. Obviously it's there. It's about these two characters, but there's also this whole other sci-fi, like, political relationship plot thing going on where these two, the humans and the aliens, are trying, and the only reason I'm saying aliens is because I have no idea how to say what the aliens are called, so I'm not even going to try, are trying to create a relationship with one another, but they have completely different political structures. I mean, obviously Earth, even there you have like a kajillion political structures and cultural norms and like economic policies. So it's already difficult there. And then just other things within the context of the story makes it more strained, and you have to see this push and pull, and these two teenagers kind of get caught up in that. And I love the way Melissa Landers handles the idea of neither group is necessarily wrong about the way that they live their lives. They can both provide good things to the other, but she doesn't write about either one in a judgmental way. Like, she's not saying that one is right and one is wrong. By the end of the series, there's definitely some things that are left unresolved, especially from like a plot perspective, like the more politically plot sci-fi stuff. But I'm satisfied with where it ended. Lately, I've been kind of into slightly more open endings, I guess. I feel like I've been saying a lot that like, there's questions I still have answers, or need answers for, but I'm okay. So if like she was able to get another book deal and have a third book, I would gladly read it and would be excited to spend more time with these characters and in this world, but I don't need that. Like, I am more than satisfied right now. So like I usually do in my reviews, last thing is, would I recommend this series? And I have to say, yes. I like the plots and the characters. I think they have pretty broad appeal. I don't think the romance is too much. So if that is something you're a little iffy about, I don't think that would detract for you. It's also not crazy sci-fi heavy. Like, the sci-fi is very approachable, and the language isn't super crazy, and even with the aliens, because they're so humanoid, a lot of the things, like their behaviors and things, are still easy to comprehend versus aliens that maybe, like, are less humanoid. So those are my thoughts on Alienated, the series by Melissa Landers. If you have any questions, comments, anything like that, as long as it's not spoilery, please feel free to leave it down in the comments below. And thank you so much for watching. Bye!